We see these pictures all the time, on places like Facebook and Instagram, staged photos of shirtless fathers holding their naked babies. Did you know they are sharing bacteria with their babies when they do this? So is skin bonding a good activity or a bad activity for fathers to do? And are these fathers in the photos just artsy hipster posers doing glam shots? Deserving to get smashed with a banana? Well, I'll tell you what science knows about this, and I'll chime in my own personal opinion. I'm Koaw of Koaw Nature, and this channel is all about helping my fellow millennials reconnect with nature so we can be better role models for our younger generation. And this video is especially for you millennial parents. And today we are addressing an abundant species of animal on this planet, humans. And I'm going to tie in our symbiotic relationships with many different and essential species within an entirely different domain. When I say bacteria, I bet you start thinking of other words like disease and bad and nasty and gross and unhealthy. But I'm gonna lay down a few facts so you lose some of that bias against bacteria. Bacteria have been on this planet for a few billion years. We co-evolved with these microscopic organisms, and we wouldn't be able to survive in this world without the trillions of cells of bacteria living in our bodies. That is, unless we wanted to live in a bubble. An average dude like me has about 40 trillion bacterial cells in my body. And that's compared to about the 30 trillion cells that hold my own DNA. So I have more foreign cells in my body than I do of my own. Same with you. There are about 10,000 microbial species within us, weighing about 3 pounds in total. And our microbiome, all the microbes and their genes, provide us with many necessary services, like breaking down carbohydrates and creating food and vitamins. We all share a similar microbiome in that it is carrying out similar functions in our body, but as individuals, we have different microbiota, or different species living within us and on us. So recently I've been doing a lot of research on kids and nature. And of course I've come across some awesome materials, but I found this book, which is just amazing. And I'm gonna plug it at the end without shame, because I feel every millennial parent, either with young kids or with a newborn or that's expecting, should have it. Before we are born, we are protected by a placenta, which prevents other foreign invaders like most other bacteria and viruses from interacting with us. So when a baby is born, it needs to acquire all of those essential microbes that have important functions for our bodies. For babies born by vaginal births, these neonates immediately collect vaginal microbes and fecal matter from their mother and acquire other essential bacteria that will have long-lasting health benefits. And of course, many births can't be done vaginally. They have to be done via cesarean section or C-section because of possible risks to the mother or the possibility of spreading a sexually transmitted disease to the baby. So babies born via C-sections miss out on this initial opportunity to gain important microbes unless the parents opt to do something called vaginal seeding. But once a baby is born and held against their mother's breast and begin breastfeeding, they also acquire bacteria from their mother's skin, nipple, and milk. All of this will help the baby build a functional microbiome. Breastfeeding and skin-to-skin contact, or skin bonding, is also quite essential for healthy interactions and relational developments between mother and baby. Again, assuming there is no transmittable disease to worry about. And there is a plethora of research supporting the benefits, both psychological and physiological, of skin bonding between a mother and her child. But what about dads? Well, in these progressive times, as societies are starting to realize that the other parent that didn't deliver the child plays an important role in that child's development, we're starting to see research. We're seeing research done on the positive benefits of skin-to-skin bonding between father and baby, especially in those moments right after birth and in those weeks afterwards. But don't get me wrong, this area is still lacking a lot of research. But there is evidence that suggests that skin bonding between father and baby does not only confer positive results for the baby, but also positive benefits for the father. One study found that the fathers who participated in skin bonding with their newborn alleviated their anxieties and established more confidence in the responsibility and ability to take care of their child. And a father, when skin bonding with a child, is also sharing his skin and oral microbes with the child. And I would love to lay some science down and say that the skin-to-skin contact between father and baby and the sharing of the father's bacteria to the baby offers beneficial results for the baby, but I can't. Why? Because there's no research out there. So that doesn't mean that the sharing of microbes between father or the other partner to the baby is bad or good. It just means that we don't have any empirical evidence to suggest that it's good or bad. It means some scientists need to get some grants and start working on this. Though a breastfeeding baby or one that's engaging in skin-to-skin contact with one parent will still be getting a good deal of both parents' skin microbes because a mother and her partner are usually engaging in a different form of skin-to-skin contact. Wink, wink. In sum, I do know that I will be skin bonding with my baby one day, should a lady ever find me to be a suitable mate. Ladies, my microbes are awesome. And as far as these fathers being good, bad, or just artsy hipster bags of D posing for glam shots, well, these aren't mutually exclusive criteria. But I'd have to say that these skin bonding fathers are doing a great thing for themselves, their baby, and their partner. And once the research gets done, I'm sure that it will show that this skin-to-skin contact and the sharing of microbes between father to baby will confer positive benefits for the babies. The main takeaways here, bacteria are not always bad. They're essential for our survival, and yes, at times they can kill us, but we have a whole plethora of species living within and on us that are beneficial. Babies need to acquire foreign microbes for a healthy start in this world, and skin-to-skin bonding fathers are doing a good job. But if you are posting glam photos online to show off your mad parenting skills, you are most likely also a pretentious artsy poser deserving a banana smashed in your face. Please share this video if you think your bros or gal pals would like to learn a thing or two, and subscribe over there if you haven't already. It's time for you to spread some knowledge and be nature heroic. And if you like what we're doing here at Koaw Nature and you want to be a part of it, check out my Patreon link down below. I know my sister would love this book. I hope she's watching this video. This is the one that I feel that every millennial parent, either with young kids, newborn, or expecting, should have, because it takes an esoteric topic like microbiology and makes it very simple to understand, answering so many questions that new parents have. Questions like, does it matter if I breastfeed? Can antibiotics lead to obesity for my baby? Is having a dog in the house good for my baby? What role does the microbiome play in my child's food allergies? And they write it responsibly. They don't just make up shit. If the science doesn't know right now where we're at, they say the science doesn't know. But it answers many questions. And even for me, I only have nieces and nephews right now. I feel that just having this information is preparing me very well for my future days as a father, should that ever happen. So if you want to buy it on Amazon, I put the link below. You can get a hardback or Kindle. I like to write my books. And if you buy it within the link that I put down below, then Koaw Nature will get a small finder's fee, which helps me buy more books so I can make more videos for you guys. And I'll thank you with positive vibes. This really was a marvelous find. So, thank you for watching. Have a good day.
You enjoying it? You enjoyed it?
Oh, it's so fun.